They tower over some of the city's most high-profile areas, monuments like the one of Robert E. Lee at Dallas Lee Park and others near City Hall, paying homage to the Civil War and its leaders.
It would be inappropriate for these statues that honor slave owners, stealers of human bodies, human traffickers. It would be inappropriate even if there was not a single person of color in Dallas.
To Michael Phillips, an author and Collin College history professor, they've simply got to go.
These statues were put in place in an era when, number one, it was the height of lynching. Number two, it was a period of disenfranchisement, poll taxes and literacy tests. And number three, it was a period of segregation. And to keep those monuments there today says we still have the same values.
Phillips would also like to see the names of several Dallas schools changed, including Stonewall Jackson and Robert E. Lee Elementaries. It's the latest round in a fiercely divided debate. Texas Senator Brandon Creighton from Conroe outside Houston slipping Senate Bill 112 into the special session. He says to preserve history and prevent renaming. In a statement, he says we should not delete evidence of our past to comply with current political correctness. Those monuments are a great way to learn and teach future generations as parents see fit. Phillips says he's not trying to delete history, just change its presentation.
The Germans had decided to leave in place all the swastikas carved into public buildings in Germany after World War II, because it's quote-unquote history. The past, people know about their past in Germany. They don't need to live under the shadow of swastikas forever because of that.
Now, Phillips says those monuments should be removed and stored for now, but he says really he would like to see them in museums where scholars can explain their significance. Clarice?
Thanks, Natalie.